Hello, and welcome to Novel Methods for Synthesizing Self-Amplifying RNA Vaccines, Improve Yields, and Accelerate GMP Manufacturing. I'm Anton McCaffrey, and I'm Senior Director of Emerging Science and Innovation at TriLink BioTechnologies. TriLink BioTechnologies was founded 23 years ago to synthesize highly modified oligonucleotides. And in the last 9 years or so, we've been the original and leading contract manufacturer for messenger RNA and have synthesized thousands of messenger RNAs. We by far have more experience doing contract manufacturing of messenger RNAs than anyone else in the world. We also have some proprietary capping technologies that I'll tell you about today called CleanCap. And we have 8 clean room suites for GMP manufacturing of messenger RNA, oligonucleotides such as single guide RNAs for CRISPR, NTPs, custom small molecules, and we just launched a service for GMP manufacturing of plasmid DNA, which should reduce mRNA manufacturing lead times by bringing the plasmid part and the mRNA part under a single roof. So we're a contract manufacturer, and we don't manufacture any of our own drugs for our own pharmaceutical programs. And we can provide you with complete mRNA solutions, whether you have a lot of experience making messenger RNA, or perhaps you've worked with viral vectors in the past and have never done messenger RNAs but would like to transition. We can walk you through that process from start to finish with out-of-the-box solutions for your mRNA manufacturing, whether you need us to tell you how to do the whole thing. We also have customers that walk in the door with their own batch records and simply want us to manufacture to their specifications. So what are mRNAs used for? So messenger RNAs are very popular in the genome editing field for expressing Cas9 to do CRISPR-Cas9, for example, or for zinc finger nucleases, TALENs, meganucleases. They're also used in gene replacement for things like urea cycle disorders or lysosomal storage diseases. And they were increasingly popular in immunobiology, whether that's manufacturing CAR T cells by doing genome editing to them, in manufacturing vaccines for infectious disease, as you've seen in the news lately for COVID-19. They're also used for personalized cancer vaccines in which a tumor is sequenced in a patient and neoantigens that are only present in the tumor are identified. These neoantigens can then be expressed in a messenger RNA to make a personalized vaccine for that individual patient and recruit the immune system to target that tumor. And today I'm going to tell you about an exciting technology called self-amplifying RNA vaccines. And these are called SAM RNAs or sometimes Assay RNAs. So Assay RNAs or SAM RNAs are self-replicating RNAs that are usually based on alphaviruses. And these are an exciting platform for vaccine development that is receiving more and more attention. And in these alphavirus backbones, the structural proteins that form the viral capsid are deleted and an antigen of interest is put in their place. And thus, the replicon cannot make an infectious virus. However, as it replicates through a double-stranded RNA intermediate, it stimulates innate immunity and enhances both T-cell responses and antibody responses. And a single molecule of RNA that enters the cytoplasm can be converted into tens of thousands of copies in the transfected cell. And as a result, these require very low doses. So for example, 1 microgram, it may be sufficient for each administration. And that compares to standard mRNA vaccines that require 50 or 100 micrograms doses. And these new vaccines can be produced very rapidly in response to pandemics. So generally these RNAs are made through in vitro transcription and then formulated into a lipid nanoparticle. And that is injected into the muscle. And once the RNA enters the cell, the positive strand genome, which has the non-structural genes makes the RNA-dependent RNA polymerase, which will replicate the RNA to produce the negative strand genome and then more positive strand genomes, while the antigen of interest replaces the structural protein so that there's no infectious virus produced. And the positive strand and the negative strand are in a double-stranded intermediate during part of the life cycle. And so this double-stranded intermediate activates innate immune sensors such as PKR, MDA5, and RIG-I, which are there to sense RNA viruses. And so this greatly stimulates the innate immune system and leads to very good humoral and innate immune responses, while the subgenomic promoter drives expression of the antigen of interest. And these can be produced very rapidly. Once a circulating strain has been sequenced and published on the internet, you can use gene assembly to produce a DNA template rapidly and then do an in vitro transcription to make the mRNA. This is then formulated in lipid nanoparticle and injected into the patient, and the vaccine self-amplifies in a way that mimics a viral infection. And this induces an immune response that's protective against the pathogen of interest, for example, COVID-19. However, there's a little bit of a conundrum in production of these alphavirus RNAs. And that is that these alphaviruses start with a 5' AUG. However, T7 RNA polymerase very strongly prefers to initiate with GTP. And so what researchers traditionally have done is that they've appended an extra G onto the 5' end of the alphavirus genome. However, the Frolov lab has shown that when you append sequences to the 5' end of an alphavirus and then passage these through a cell, that the virus very rapidly reverts back to having a 5' AUG. This suggests that there's some kind of a selective pressure that prefers to have that 5' AUG sequence. Now, when you have a G at the end, you can cap these RNAs using enzymatic capping. However, this generally involves a purification step prior to capping with the vaccinia virus capping enzymes. And these RNAs are quite long, usually 9 to 16 kb, and are easily degraded during purification. And so if you can avoid this purification step, it's highly desirable. They're also quite expensive at scale. And the capping can be inefficient when you have a structured 5' end, such as that of the alpha virus, and you usually require heating to disrupt that structure prior to capping. And this can also lead to degradation of the messenger RNA. So at TriLink, we developed a unique solution called CleanCap AU. You can see that molecule down here. It's basically a capped trimer. And so CleanCap AU allows us to initiate T7 transcription with the authentic AUG start site. And the capping efficiency is extremely high. And it's not influenced by a 5' structure because it's co-transcriptional. And so you can do a one-pot synthesis with no need for a purification step prior to the capping. And this process yields a high yield of approximately 4 mg/mL. We also have another reagent called CleanCap AG that can be used for making traditional messenger RNAs that are not alpha viruses. Now, in order to assess the capping status of a messenger RNA, which is actually quite challenging because we're looking for the addition of a single methyl group to an RNA that can be millions of Daltons in length, we developed a capping assay at TriLink, in which we cleave off the 5' end of the RNA, and then we use LC-MS to address the capping status of that RNA. On the left here, you can see an enzymatic capping reaction that has not gone to completion. And so these are partially capped RNAs, whereas with CleanCap, in a single step, we get very high levels of capping. And so we're very enthusiastic about this, and this has been very rapidly adopted. And because we can reduce the number of steps from 4 to 2, and reduce the number of enzymes used by 2. And we can do this in a single pot reaction, and it's highly efficient and reproducible and robust process. And compared to traditional co-transcriptional capping methods that yield only about 70% cap material and leave very low yields, we can achieve about 3 times the yield of cap material compared to traditional co-transcriptional capping methods. And this is just a case study of a vaccine that we manufactured for Robin Shattuck's group at Imperial College of London. And you can see that in a very short time period from when we were contacted by the client, we were able to produce a GMP grade messenger RNA that was suitable for formulation. And so this is really kind of a revolution in vaccine manufacturing, in that, you know, it used to take years to make a vaccine, and now you're seeing accelerated development of vaccines and really in a period of just a few months. And so we think that this is quite a game changer. And at TriLink, we're committed to meeting your manufacturing needs as you expand. And so we moved into a new purpose-built facility at the end of last year that has 105,000 square feet of space with 55,000 square feet of custom design manufacturing and laboratory space. And we have 8 GMP suites with ISO class 7 and ISO class 8 suites and class 5 hoods. We also just announced the launching of a new production facility for plasmids. We have 2 production lines with ISO class 8 space suitable for GMP manufacturing, supporting critical raw materials for mRNA-based vaccines and therapeutics. And we can manufacture API through phase 2A. Each line has individual suites for every unit operation and are only used for one product at a time. And we use single-use consumables from start to finish to minimize the risk of contamination. And these have ISO class 7 and ISO class 8 engineered cGMP customer suites with class 5 finish fill hoods. And so we can support you from your early research grade manufacturing through your phase 1 manufacturing at scales of micrograms to grams to scale up, and finally your phase 2 material from at scales of grams to kilograms. We also have a highly developed quality system. We're ISO 9001:2015 certified. Our GMP facility is also compliant with ICH Q7 Section 19 guidelines. And whether you're making a research grade material with us or a GMP material, all our materials are fully traceable. And we're frequently audited by our clients. And we can support material grades that range from basic research through diagnostic grades, preclinical and toxicology studies, and finally your clinical trials. We also have a highly experienced GMP team that has shepherded many GMP jobs through. Down here in the bottom, this is Jessica Madigan, who leads that team. And they have a lot of experience doing GMP mRNA manufacturing, and they can guide you through this process from start to finish. And we highly encourage you to contact them early on to make sure that your program goes seamlessly from research grade and tox all the way through to your GMP manufacturing. And you can contact them at these email addresses you see here. And with that, I will end the presentation, and I thank you for your attention.